İlk defa İstanbul'da olan Melisa Afdar Mağar ile birlikteyiz. Kendisi Hole ve Smashing Pumpkins'ten tanıdığımız çok önemli kadın rock figürlerinden bir tanesi. Dolayısıyla bu akşam kendisini ilk defa izleyeceğimiz için oldukça heyecanlıyım. Kendisine sorularımı yöneltiyorum. First of all, welcome to Turkey. Your long-awaited and long-delayed second album titled Out of Our Minds was released back in March. Why did the release got delayed so much despite the album was ready for release since 2007?
Many reasons why there was a long, lovely delay between my first and second album. Professional reasons, musical reasons, personal reasons, but mainly because the record industry, the music industry has changed so much in the middle of making this record. My former label, Capitol Records, EMI, everybody was fired in one day right as I was going to mix the record, and it created a one-year legal debate. All of that to say is I have no complaints, because in fact the best thing that's ever happened to me as an artist is to be released from the large corporate record industry and be able to be free as an artist. So what ended up happening is in the few years that followed my release from the major label is I ended up exploring and expanding as an artist and making Out of Our Minds more than an album, diving into a fantasy film and all of the extra multimedia components that I could create out of the spirit of the music and the songs. And I feel I finally arrived as a well-rounded artist with Out of Our Minds. And although it was unfortunate, I basically disappeared and went underground and hid in the woods for 3 years of my life without any live shows or releases. But it was, I believe I've come out a stronger, better artist for it. So I give Out of Our Minds after a long search. And I became my own manager, record label, production company, self-financed all of it myself in the end. So it was a very good lesson as a businesswoman as well.
Your album was released with a comic book accompanying, and also a short film was released shortly after. How did this idea came to life?
I was raised with a really wonderful education in Montreal, Canada. I went to an art school my whole life. So from 6 years old till 22, I was doing theater, music, visual arts, photography, painting, art history. So my whole life for me has been about finding the message and then using all the tools, all the beautiful artistic tools there are in the world to share it. When I was invited to join Hole and then later the Pumpkins and then with my first solo record even, I was the world told me, the universe told me that I had to do full-time music, and I put all of my artistic things to the side. So my studies in photography and film and storytelling had to go aside for almost 10 years. And so when I started the writing of my second record, I promised myself that as an artist I would return to my passions and try to make one project that could hold all of my influences, which are music is the center, but there's all these incredible things that I pull from in film and art and even painting movements. Out of Our Minds, the film was inspired as much by Pre-Raphaelite painting as it is by psychedelic rock. So it's just a project that represents all of my passions in one.
You've been an active member in both Smashing Pumpkins and Hole, fronted by two important figures in rock music, Billy Corgan and Courtney Love. How do you comment on the experience of working with them and their on and off love-hate relationship effects of their work and members of both bands, respectively?
Good question. complicated question, but I obviously, Billy and Courtney are very much like a spiritual big brother and sister to me. They open the doors to music to me and forever will be soulmates, spiritual. All of the things that happened with Hole and the Pumpkins for me was part of my destiny as a personal, artistic, and spiritual journey in my life. None of it was about business or big bands or little bands. It was about, for some reason, these two people were meant to be in my life and opened incredible experiences for me, and I learned so much from them, as they are some of the most extreme and strong people I will ever know. So to work under the two of them was an absolute honor and pleasure, mainly because I got to learn. You don't learn from like subtle, boring situations. You learn from strong, extreme situations. And In my case with Hole, I would say that Courtney and I are eternally bonded as women who were couldn't be more different as people. We, and even musically, we're very, very opposite, but we had one thing in common, which is we were women that wanted to represent women in music. So forever, Courtney and I are united in our faith in the other, wanting to bring attention to women on, in a male-dominated rock field. So that is my real experience with Hole, was that Courtney and I, at the end of the day, all of our differences aside, it was about representing women, and it was about a life experience. The human experiences and lessons I learned with her. I joined, you know, in an extreme situation, having replaced a bass player that died a few months after her husband, who committed suicide. There was, you know, little Francis. There was, like, family. There was tragedy. There was drugs. There was sadness. It was a human experience more than it was even a musical experience. And then it was a woman experience more than it was a music experience. It was a very, very destined and beautiful time in my life. Courtney found me through Billy. So Billy is sort of the gatekeeper that introduced me, and he was my first musical hero. So hearing the first Smashing Pumpkins album was what inspired me to pick up the bass. So the fact that I got to join my favorite band is became a dream come true as far as the rock dream of a music fan. So Billy represents sort of like the dream that if you can dream the biggest dream and you can achieve it. And he and I were both born on St. Patrick's Day with Irish descent, and we are clearly connected from another place as well as a musical place, and in this life but other lives. And he is my big brother, who in my year with them during the farewell tour for the end of their first chapter, it was the best music lesson of my life. I mean, and it would make sense that his music inspired me to play music, and my year with them traveling the world and learning 150 plus catalog of songs was the best music lesson I could have ever had. Billy's one of the hardest working, most talented musicians I'll ever work with. So that was the big music soulmate connection. And I'm very lucky to have had such extreme big brothers and sisters.
Did you get the chance to see Smashing Pumpkins after their reunion?
I haven't seen either reunion. I haven't seen the Hole or Pumpkins reunion yet. No, I'm completely open to it. I would love to see it, actually. I just haven't been in the same cities as them, and in fact I haven't crossed paths with either Billy and Courtney very often. I mean, we live very different lives, and I'm hiding in the woods up in the cold winter land, and they're in on the west side of the country. I don't see them very often, but I feel them. But I'm very curious. I'd love to see it.
How was living in New York's infamous Chelsea Hotel for some time, and how did the experience treat you both as a artist and as a person?
Yeah.
Who choose to live alone at a hotel room?
Yeah, well, the Chelsea Hotel obviously represents a very exciting time in music and art. For me, the Velvet Underground, Andy Warhol movement that happened in the 70s was one of my first passions as a teenager. When I discovered that scene, I read every book, I listened to every record. I took a trip when I was 16 to the Chelsea Hotel to take pictures of me in front of it. So it was always a mythological fantasy dream for me to live there. And when I was living in New York, I was given this option to rent the most beautiful, perfect little apartment. And it was right when I was starting to make my first record. So it was this perfect year of living a fantasy art music dream. And I began to make my first record living there, and it was great. I mean, you have people down in the lobby who receive all of your packages. You can order. I could stay in my hotel for 3 weeks and just have everything brought room service to my room. I loved it. I loved being able to live out that dream, and it was a great place for me to start my personal solo project.
Thank you so much for your time. Good luck on the
stage. My pleasure. Thank you for having me. Turkey, I hear your Eastern melodies in my head, and I've never been here, but I know that another part of my life has been here, and I hear the melodies, and I've been dreaming to sing Follow the Waves in this city and in this country, because I think that there's a musical, you have a tradition of music in your culture, and so do I in mine, and I will discover the mystery this weekend of where these melodies come from and how they can influence me for my next record. So thank you. Yes, you are dreaming. And yes, I am Melissa Oftermauer. You are watching Dream TV, and I am falling in love with Istanbul.